Avril Lavigne is dead.
Who's that?
Some teen rock star singer or whatever. Very famous somebody.
You know, Aaliyah. Aaliyah died a long time ago. She was a famous singer.
This woman has a, not a clone, but someone who's really close looking to her. I guess a lot of people believe that she actually committed suicide.
Oh, so this is one of those clone cases.
Yeah, kind of like the Tim Tebow thing or whatever.
Well, there's a lot of them. There's rappers like Gucci Mane. They said Eminem's a clone. So it's the clone stuff. And yeah, it's interesting. It's always musicians. Now, there's a couple of famous people like Joe Biden or somebody people think is a clone. But it's usually just certain musicians. They end up becoming cloned. And I wonder if the music industry is just a gateway for these clone industries to test it. Because musicians are famous. Everybody knows them. They have a certain sound resonance. And then if they can perfect it and nobody can tell, they know they're perfecting their clone technology.
And if they ever say anything, the FDR or the whoever will come and schwack them. And then they'll just replace them with the clone.
You know, and the more I'm thinking about it, it kind of makes sense. Because the whole music industry is where we get all this Illuminati talk from. Not too many people outside the music industry talks about it. But it's propagated and it's popular in the music industry specifically. So it wouldn't be weird because they always die. Like all these musicians somehow always get in weird scenarios where they always get assassinated by one way or another. Maybe there's a real connection between the clone industry, the music industry, and the way to deal with it is through the guise of the Illuminati.
What about the gals?
Well, I'm just saying the Illuminati may not be real, but because people believe it enough and it's circulated around the music industry, it's a way to say, oh, they were involved in the Illuminati, so they got assassinated or whatever. But really, that's just a way for people to not speculate that it was the clone industry getting rid of these clones. And the music industry is really just a gateway to propagate the clone technology. Because it is the easiest way to test if it worked or not. Because if you can convince the masses that this is not a clone, they think it's still the original artist, you have perfected your clone. Like even sound, speech, interviews, music, the appearance, everything. The mannerisms.
Well, that you could be onto something, honestly. I think people need to hear this. This is good
stuff.
But to
me, it's interesting. I just connected those dots just now because, you know, the Illuminati in its base sense is kind of stupid. But if it's used as just a guise, then it's genius. Especially if you can get people to believe that it has some legitimacy. Then it's genius.